Hey guys, welcome back to the Regenerate channel. So, we have some news on the upcoming Cemu 1.7.6 build. This information comes on the heels of the public release of Cemu 1.75, and it brings with it some interesting insight into the direction the next build is going to take, and I suspect it also explains why we've seen so many issues with Cemu 1.75. As many of you know, Cemu 1.75 has been ripe with issues in unexpected ways. In many games like Zelda Breath of the Wild, stability and performance has increased, while also introducing a slew of new graphical glitches. But we also saw some games like Star Fox Zero not even boot up as they were doing in previous builds. I suspect that this has something to do with Exzap's latest news regarding the new direction that Cemu is taking in build 1.76 and how Cemu handles its shader processing. The technical details are complicated for anyone unfamiliar, but from what I understand, Team Cemu is going to be changing how Cemu crunches through your shader data in an attempt to increase efficiency and performance even further. This means that they'll be using tools available to them within modern OpenGL to handle shaders on an individual basis instead of how they were previously handling shaders, which was in an inefficient way by coupling them for processing through the rendering API, or application programming interface. This appears to be no small undertaking, and it will take some time to implement this new system. But once this process of changing the system over is complete, it should go a long way to speed up compilation and processing times where shaders are concerned. The only downside is that changing how shaders are handled in Cemu means that all past shader caches and any custom shaders in the way of graphic packs will no longer be compatible with Cemu 1.76. This is a fair trade-off, though, for faster shader compilation, better performance in Cemu, and less RAM usage overall. That's all for now. So what do you think of these new changes by Team Cemu? Share your comments down below, and be sure to hop over to the Regenerate Discord server to join the community there for discussion on all things emulation. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.